Dinosaur Stories by Miles Kelly, written by Katherine Veitch and Fran Bromage. Plateosaurus, the Selfish Dinosaur, illustrated by Catalina Echeverri. A young Plateosaurus called Posy once lived near a dusty desert. She had a best spot beside a river. Posy was a selfish dinosaur. If she found her favorite liverwort leaves growing nearby, she wouldn't tell her friends. "There's no liverwort here," she would say, and send them looking in the opposite direction. Every day, Posy played rock skittles. There was always a queue of other dinosaurs waiting to play, but Posy wouldn't share. Once, a brave little eruptor called Esme dared to ask for a turn in her biggest voice. "Please, can I play?" Posy held on tight to her rock and said, "No, you can't play. These are my skittles. Go away." Each day, dinosaurs had to cross a bridge over the river to reach the shady trees on the other side. Posy wouldn't let them cross. She said, "This is my bridge and you can't cross here." So all the dinosaurs had to go the longer way around. Things carried on like this until a new dinosaur moved into the desert. The new dinosaur's name was Malik, and he was a Melanorosaurus. And Malik was just as selfish as Posy. One hot day, Malik started to cross the bridge to reach the shady side of the river. "Get off my bridge!" shouted Posy. "It's my bridge now!" shouted Malik. The other dinosaur suggested that Posy and Malik have a competition. The winner of the competition would be the owner of the bridge. First, they had a race. "And the winner is Posy!" shouted Esme. "I won! I'm the winner!" cried Posy. "It's my bridge!" Next, there was a log lifting contest to see who was the strongest. Posy gripped a log in her jaws and heaved it in the air. But Malik hauled an even bigger log higher than Posy did. "Malik is the winner!" shouted Charlie the Silophysis. "Who can jump the highest?" asked Esme. Posy and Malik both leapt into the air at the same time. Esme and Charlie measured their jumps. "I won! I won!" shouted Posy. "No, you didn't! I jumped higher than you!" shouted Malik. There was a hush as the winner was announced. "It's a draw," said Charlie. Posy and Malik had both won. They were too surprised to speak. But Posy and Malik didn't like being winners together. They didn't want to share the bridge. They argued long into the afternoon. Suddenly, everyone heard a loud roar. Then from the forest came a huge, stomping, roaring beast. It marched towards the bridge. "It's a Euskalosaurus! Run!" shouted Posy and Malik. "Rah!" There was a crazy bundle as the little dinosaur sped off. Posy and Malik stood side by side on the bridge. "No one is crossing our bridge," they said. They rose onto their back legs and bared their teeth and claws. The Euskalosaurus stopped in its tracks. "Get off our bridge!" shouted Posy and Malik together. Posy and Malik's plan worked. The Euskalosaurus turned its back and slunk away into the forest. "He won't dare step on our bridge again," they laughed. Everyone heard how Posy and Malik worked together to scare away the Euskalosaurus. "Has the mean dinosaur really gone?" asked Esme. "Yes, and it's not coming back," smiled Posy. "It's more fun doing things together," Posy said. Malik agreed. and from then on, they shared the breeds with everyone. Hi, if you like this video, please give this a like and hit the subscribe button and click the bell icon to get notified whenever I release a new video.